two of the times we failed, the times we have sinned. And so recall these as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God of peace, who are peace itself, and whom the spirit of discord cannot grasp, nor a violent mind receive, grant that those who are one in heart may persevere in what is good, and that those in conflict may forget evil and so be healed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burden them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They named him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice shall flourish.
I'm reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also do. And over all of these, put on love. That is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you. truth be told, it wasn't so much that the individual's name stuck with her, but she would, upon meeting someone new, immediately make some sort of association with that person, and ultimately connect that association then with the name that she would then recall. Now, it could be as far-fetched as remembering the place of that first encounter with someone else, to what their favorite food was, to how many E's or A's or O's were in the name. She just had this knack for remembering based on association. In these modern times, today's a day of remembering. And for many who had family members or friends that served in the armed forces for our country, I'm certain that there's really no need of making any kind of association with that individual so that you would be able to remember who they are. Your remembering of them goes much deeper than that. Your remembering of them continues to occupy a place in your heart. For all of us, our presence here today on this Memorial Day is our way of remembering and honoring those who have sacrificed so much so that we might be able to gather, so that we might be able to enjoy freedom, independence, so that we might remember that the peace for each and every human person is not some abstract concept, but it's really a sacred gift. It's a holy right, and it's a moral responsibility. Our gathering to remember includes all who gave of themselves, all who gave of their lives, and beyond those we knew. Those we know, certainly. Because their great sacrifice was not just for who they knew, but for so many that they did not know. Yet, so many whose human dignity, whose human rights, whose many freedoms, including the right and freedom to worship as their conscience dictated, was more important than their safety and security. Those who sacrificed their lives did so at some time because of this sacred gift, because of this holy right, this moral responsibility of peace that was not being honored as such. They sacrificed their lives so that countless others could have life. Innocent others could have life. And they were caught in the middle. And so, we must not forget them. You and I gather today to remember that the peace every heart seeks is one that's not something to be won by might, but accepted and embraced as a gift. A gift given us by God through Jesus Christ. The one who is that great light, the one who has been named Wonder Counselor, God, Hero, Father, Forever, Prince of Peace. The one whom has become God's chosen, and in turn has chosen others, and whose peace is the only peace that must ever control our hearts. So let our prayer be that those who have gone before us, those who sacrificed their lives so that we might live in peace, be honored. Honored by our living in that peace and sharing that peace with every human person. Be honored by the very way that we live our lives. Remembering not simply those who sacrificed their lives, but also remembering the evils that led to those sacrifices. The evils that put human life, human dignity, human rights, and human freedom in jeopardy. Remembering and bringing an end to those evils so that such tragic and painful sacrifices will never, ever happen again. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, may our remembering cause us to show forth heartfelt compassion, act always with kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, and never hesitate to bear with one another, to forgive one another, to love one another, just as our God loves us. Christ Jesus, continues to draw us close by the power of the Spirit. In prayer, we do just that.
That the church, her leaders, and all believers may hold fast to the God for whom all things are possible, amid these challenging and uncertain times, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of nations may set aside political differences, working to protect and safeguard the well-being of all their citizens, especially the vulnerable, and all in the Ukraine, portions of Africa, and the Americas, and throughout our world. May war give way to peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all forms of hatred give way to understanding and respect, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the men and women who give of their lives so that justice and freedom may be protected, may themselves be protected from all harm, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those living and dead who have sacrificed of their lives so that we might live in freedom and peace, may we remember this day and always, and know of our appreciation and our gratitude, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering, especially Fred Burkhart, John Chartarina, Bob Christian, Andy Firth, Floss Firth, Mike Firth, Deja Fortney, Donna Henry, Rod Hilke, Julianne Jenkins, Shirley Keller, Dan Klein, Dan Lane, Jonathan Morkowski, Tom Morkowski, Joyce Moore, Denise Petras, Nora Quattrocchio, Brooke Russell, Carol Scaling, Katrina Shum, Paula Simmons, Giovanni Testa, Janet Tree, as well as all the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may be brought to healing and restored to wholeness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Eucharistic assembly may be strengthened by the very Lord who brings us together, strengthening us by his most holy sacrament, and that any missing from our worship may draw closer to the Lord, who will accompany them back to his table, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for any of those who have recently died, and for Tom Hedrick, for whom this Mass is offered, those who have died due to acts of violence, and all of the dead, may rejoice one day in the fullness of God's eternal kingdom, and that all who mourn their loss may be comforted, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may trust in God, who knows the unspoken needs that lay deep within our hearts and minds, and those written in our prayer notes book, as well as those that we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of all that was, is, and ever will be, without thee we are nothing. We lean on your care, compassion, and mercy. May we find in the sacrifice of your Son, by the means of his resurrection, our cause and source of all hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of all justice and peace, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Our offertory chant, let's sing, "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is." Number 468.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the gift of the fruit of the earth and work of the hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine of our faith, fruit of the vine and work of your hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Let's sing verse 6.
It is the height and time.
indeed is our Son present in our midst, but we are gathered by the Son. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these offerings of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Oh, darling Father,
Savior's command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As he hung up on the cross, Jesus said to the disciple,
We have received, O Lord, the sacrament of unity. Grant us, we pray, that living in your house in holy accord, we may possess the peace we have found and preserve the peace we have received. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, Lord, by the Lord, by your life.
Thanks be to God. Let me say, this is my song, and it's number 747.